15 years ago, I was introduced to a character that would go on to become one of my all-time favorites. That character was Hellboy. Hellboy was the latest film from Guillermo del Toro. It was a comic book adaptation in the long-forgotten era called the early 2000s, where comic book movies were few and far between. Hot off the tails of his previous movie, Blade 2, another comic book adaptation, del Toro brought Mike Mignola's paranormal investigator to the big screen. The results were fantastic. The movie was enough of a success that a sequel followed shortly after del Toro's masterpiece, Pan's Labyrinth. Now with the third film coming to theaters almost 15 years to the day from a different creative team, I thought it'd be a good time to look back on the source material itself, the comic book. In the past 25 years, Hellboy has appeared in a number of series, including the main Hellboy run, Hellboy in Hell, Hellboy in the BPRD, and a series chronicling his early adventures called Hellboy 1952. Hellboy is a series that spans decades, as the hero travels the globe combating the forces of evil for the Bureau of Paranormal Research and Defense. While on his adventures, Hellboy's sinister destiny continues to reveal itself. Throughout the series, we witness Hellboy's character come in direct conflict with that destiny and the creatures of the old world. Brought to the Earth by the Nazis in 1944, Hellboy was destined to destroy the Earth. However, due to his upbringing by Professor Broom, he constantly denies that destiny in often epic ways as he carves out his own path in life. Mignola's ability to weave together intricate tales of horror fused with folklore from all around the world is second to none. The main story is often an amalgamation of European and Russian folklore taking place in a world designed by H.P. Lovecraft. His ability to craft dense stories is what draws me to the series, but it is in his one-shot stories that I truly find a reason to stick around. One such instance of this is The Wolves of St. August. The Wolves of St. August is a one-issue story that is printed in Hellboy Volume 3, The Chained Coffin, and other stories. This is the volume of the series I would recommend for anyone interested in breaking into the character, as it features some of the most famous Hellboy stories, including The Corpse and Baba Yaga, without much need for context. Set in the Balkans of Eastern Europe in a town called Griart, Hellboy is called in to investigate a series of horrific murders. A rejection of Christianity is one of the many themes that is explored in this issue, with iconography of the religion present in almost every page. The subtle parallel of the story's theme to Hellboy's theme of rejecting his own destiny is masterfully handled. This is the first Hellboy story that Mignola wrote entirely on his own. The story marks the first appearance of Field Agent Kate Corrigan as well, a recurring character in the Hellboy series. What I love about Hellboy is that you never know how significant the current moment in time you are viewing will be, as this is a series that takes place over 50 plus years and across multiple continents. As Hellboy and Kate start to investigate the murder of their friend and the townspeople, they quickly begin to determine that something about the town is not right. The history of the town is shrouded in mystery, and the scene of the crime itself reeks of a town with something to hide. They are investigating the chapel when events really take a turn for the worse. Kate falls through the floor and comes crashing down into the basement. It is here that she encounters her first ghost, and as a reader, we are drawn further into the dark story Mignola has been painting for us. His use of gothic literature tropes is in full force at this time, as we feel the sense of dread that has been building start to really close in around our characters. Hellboy quickly takes control of the situation, and then tries to get them out when they run into the murderer of their friend and the townspeople, William Greener. Immediately following the run-in with William, Mignola showcases the best werewolf transformation I've seen since American Werewolf in London, and that's saying something. What ensues next is typical of a Hellboy story, just pure, relentless combat. Mignola paints vivid pictures of folktales unknown by most people, and then he infuses them with a Jack Kirby-esque flair for dynamic movement within his panels. Often, throughout the series, Hellboy is battling the gods and monsters of time long forgotten, in direct conflict with his dark destiny, but every now and then the epic story takes a backseat to a good old-fashioned fistfight with evil. The story wraps up with Hellboy killing Greener with a makeshift spear formed by a cross. This seals the inevitable fate of the creature who was cursed hundreds of years ago for rejecting God in the first place. Mignola's story ends on one of his many magnificent punchlines. Wow, that was something. Agent Corrigan is us, the viewer, taking in our latest adventure with Hellboy.